Alrighty, everyone, welcome back to Dungeon Siege 2. We're gonna get straight off from where we were before with our little Scorpion Queen character. Heck, don't go in the middle of the Gorax. Because I don't want you to get toasted. Weak Arcane Sisters, nice. Okay, so now we've got four people in our party. We also have extra inventory room, which actually doesn't matter that much, seeing as though you can just go into town whenever you want with a teleport scroll, but it's relatively useful still. The guys are just getting annihilated. They've just got no good armor. Go in. Oh god, we can't take on that many commands. Run back! Scorpion Queen, run! Run! Every now and again the AI just like derps out. It gets so fixated on the fact that somebody in the party is getting attacked that they just do Suicide King in order to get there. Uh-oh. Gotta get that sweet orb walking going. Oh god, I actually died. I was not paying attention. Okay, well let's just respawn. We may as well just go straight back out, seeing as though we've got the teleporter right there. Holy hell! You'd think that after having over 1,000 hours on this game that I'd... Well over a couple of 1,000 hours, actually, so that I'd be better at beginning. But, no! I kind of just play my powerful characters. And then, yeah. Actually, this mod that I've got that sort of, like, rebalances the whole game, it does a decent job, but as you could tell... Actually, Derry, you just get your stuff so you don't just get one shot. As you can tell, there are some things that aren't that balanced. Good thing is that the Scorpion Queen doesn't actually need any items. So while these guys are running naked through the forest, we might still be able to do enough damage to clear them apart. I'm thinking about doing some Let's Plays of other games, by the way. I might go through the new Tomb Raiders. Those games are really, really fun. I've heard some people complain about them, but like, hell, I've found them amazing. You know, we really are just getting toasted, so I think we're gonna have to make a trip back to town in order to buy some health potions. Because we cannot make any ground. Where's Lothar? Has he got his gear back yet? Where even is it? Lothar, where are you? I can't even see him on the ground. Oh, there he is. Let's kill this guy. Alright, so we need to get him revived. And once he's been revived, we need to grab this, and then we'll make a teleporter. Alright, there we go. So let's go back. Let's get some health potions. And, God, I don't even know if we're going to be able to afford that many. Eesh. Oh, well. Go in here. Unfortunately, most of the mana that we have has to just go straight back into the field ourselves. So, let's just get as many of these as we can. Alright, that was actually not that many. Eesh. Spellbook, what have we got? Dump that. May as well dump that. We don't really need it. Resurrection scroll will keep. Wear that, I think. 17 lightning resistance, yeah. Those guys in the... What's it called? In the forest have been shooting us with lightning. Hold up, 75, 75. That restores 300, that restores 250. that's still probably better. We might buy a few mana potions just in case. But let's go. I don't think, can this character spawn anything yet? No, she's just got Earthen Embrace. You can get, summons for your characters. So after a while, once we've, sort of progressed enough to get some better magical spells, we might be able to beef up our team a little bit by adding in some cannon fodder via summon spells. It's good, because the more time in which our heroes aren't taking damage, the more time in which our characters are actually able to do stuff. You know what might actually be interesting? I might, later on in this series, get a summoning mage. Because summoned creatures are really good. And you can actually end up having a mage. I think a mage can summon up to 5 if you spec them into it. So we can have 5 extra. Done, Lopa! Gone! And in fact, where are you? This one. Whoa. So I'm actually strong enough to just face tank it. Good. Good. We actually killed it. Heck. This is brutal. Alright, Lothar off the ground. I swear to God, the autocast healing spell is the greatest thing on the planet. I don't even know how you play this game without it. You just have to wait so long in order for your mana, for your health to regen. It'd be ridiculous. Kill this thing. Let's see if we can get any loot here. Gold ring. Gold. What the hell? Have you desynced from your... No, there we go. What the? I'm like desynced from its selection ring. Whatever. I can't see outside. Alright, there we go. Hate it when you have to battle the camera. Oh god, here we go. Alright. As always, like, pseudo save point thing. Good god, we are taking so much damage. Well, Deru just fainted straight up. Okay. What are these characters? Level 12. What are we? What am I? I'm level 9. How are we supposed to kill level 12 Volks when I'm only level 9? Whatever. Is it worth just running around them? I don't even know if I can. They're like one-shotting me. I don't actually remember struggling this much. Pass. Let's see if we can just run through. Oh, my Scorpion Queen's lagging. These guys are only level 10. Oh, the Volts are chasing me. Nah, we're gonna get... Run! Great. Nothing like a little mini boss. Goofy, where are you? Good god. Alright, you know what? Stuff this. Maybe we'll take on some side quests for a bit. Because we obviously are not at a level where we can actually go on with this. Considering the fact that these guys are level 12 and we are level 9, as I said earlier. Come on. Alright, so Deru's just getting one shot over there, so she can't even survive properly. The only thing we can do do is maybe... Like, look at this thing. Even this thing's taking a ridiculously long time to kill. These do so much damage. And are so tanky as well. Good God. No, move back. Move back. What's the Scorpion Queen? Okay, so the Scorpion Queen's actually alive. Run. Oh my God. It doesn't help that you just get sniped by these things. Like, do you know what? I think it's just gonna be impossible. Why don't we... Us two will just revive. We'll go. And then, if I click Deru... Which I can't, because she's dead. Ah! Alright. Let's go back. Dummy 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 dum. How the hell do we get out of here? I think we might even have to just intentionally team wipe. Which is ridiculous. Because the only thing that we can do is just kill ourselves. You know what? We're just gonna have to die. Because Dera is not getting out of there. And we are not strong enough to save. And now, Lothar, your turn to hit the ground, boy. Okay. God. You have left 42 gold at your tomb song. You know what, buddy? You know what, Mr. Resurrection Man? You can keep it. You can keep that gold. Okay, so let's talk to you.
Welcome.
Yeah, some of my party's corpses. Okay, so, journal. Quest log, secondary. The Haku, the Haku part 2. Find Huron the Haku. Well, I know we can't do that. Okay, what quests do we actually have available here? The pet store has a quest for us. There should be some others at the tavern. There's also a personal quest of Taar's, which we can do. But we'd have to dump the Scorpion Queen in order to actually get it. Oh, there's the Elven Runes quest, actually.
Greetings. Are you here to buy a pet? Alas, nothing unusual. But I've been trying to acquire some dire wolves lately. Ever since I discovered they existed.
Okay,
alas,
do we have
no.
Ah,
there is a noteworthy... Excellent.
Okay, so now we're... Oh my God. You know what? You can just... Why don't you eat what you've got, and then you can tick off to the inn for a bit, and we'll go get Taar. Which, coincidentally, is actually right next to the Great Hall side quest that we have to do. So, this should be fun, doing a whole bunch of side quests in order to actually progress through the game, because we are too piss weak to do it ourselves! This rebalancing mod, really, really does wonders for the pace of the game. Alright, Taar.
Let me join you.
You're right. Come with me. Now. Let's make you a summoning mage, because...
You may have traveled far, but I will wager you have not encountered the kind of terrible beasts that I have dealt with.
Petzel the Nelda? Petzela Nedda? Has asked me to find a direwolf. She said you might know where to acquire one.
Oh, is that all? Oh my, she doesn't expect much. Well, a test to my abilities is always welcome. But I will need accompaniment. There will be gnoll beasts to contend with, as well as Morden Growl mages, who often patrol the rift locations. If that doesn't frighten you, join me and I'll attempt it. What say you?
I will do it. Where do we go from here?
Good. Head out the south gate. Follow the path as if you were going to the...
Alright, I actually know where that is, so I don't really need to talk to him.
Now, is it this person in here that has Taar's quest? I can't remember. Or she might have the Almondloo Orchid? No, it is Taar's quest.
Taar, I hear you're planning on leaving the village. At a time like this, are you mad?
I have no fear of any Morden.
Morden are the least of your worries. There's a monster lurking in the forest.
The Haku Beast? Come, Ariane, that creature never existed.
That's what everyone says. All I know is that it nearly killed us.
Are you sure you know what you're talking about?
Listen, Catral and I were in the woods several weeks ago when we stumbled across its lair. I saw it. Teeth like blades, horrible eyes that pierced right through you. It was terrifying. And it pursued us right to the town gates. We're lucky to be alive.
Ariane, the jungle heat has got the better of you. Do you really expect me to believe such a wild tale?
Why won't you believe me?
You know, it's weird because that's the only part of, I think, this entire game where a side quest gets a, like, cutscene like that. Actually, no, Amarin's does, but the cutscene is just so random, but whatever.
I will look into this, but only to prove you wrong, Ariane, for your own sake.
Alright.
They say it serves the Haku. It lives in a magical cave and it will destroy anyone that trespasses onto Haku's sacred ground. It's such a vile beast that the Haku must sacrifice a living being just to call it up. They use a magical ceremonial blade to do the deed. And as soon as they call the beast, even they must flee because it will kill everything in sight.
That sounds like the foolishness of a mind too easily swayed by a child's tale.
Wait, there's more. There's only one way to kill the beast. By using a blade blessed with the magic of the ones who command it. The Haku.
Ariane, you are living needlessly in fear. I will find this lair and reassure you that there is no such beast.
You will know the truth, but by then it will be too late. It will kill you.
It will do no such thing. And besides, there is nothing I like better than learning the truth.
You cannot approach the beast's lair unprotected.
Oh,
if you hope to defeat it, you must first equip yourself with a magical Haku blade.
So
the infidels
much exposition.
Have many camps in the northern jungle. I have heard their foul drums beating every night. Surely you will be able to find one of their blades in the ritual camps. I know of at least one ritual camp far to the north, near the river.
I will go, Ariane, but I seriously doubt I'm going to find either blade or monster.
Okay. So the first thing we need is the blade. Now, can we talk to anyone else here? We can actually do the quest without needing to first talk to people. Which is nice, because if you come across something and you just do it, you don't have to activate the quest first before you can complete the quest, if that makes sense. So if someone's asking you to, oh, go find the magical artifact in these runes, then you can actually just, while you're walking around the runes themselves, you can find that magical artifact for yourself. So, once again, another episode where we really have not actually accomplished much. Hopefully by the end of this we'll have some guidance as to what we're doing. What can we talk to here? So the northern jungle. Northern Graylin jungle. Let's go here, and I can't actually remember where the ceremonial blade is, so hopefully we can just maybe just get some XP from killing the monsters, maybe get some gear for Deru. We also have to spec Taar properly. So what can you do? You've got Earthen Embrace. Lesser Nourish is trash. Wrath of the Bear is pretty good because it's extra crit damage. Lesser Ripple, Lesser Resurrect, Transmute, Encase takes way too much mana. And Lesser Nourish. Actually, do we have. Yes. Alright, good. That's your priority in order. And then you are going to be a Summoning Mage. So. So hopefully she can now actually do something. We've got those scrolls, which is good. Oh, okay, there we go.
So there's the Haku ritual camp. Which means we just have to... How the heck do we get there? Is this by the bridge over here? Oh, hey. Alright, level 4. This would be good. We can cleave through these enemies. It's so satisfying when you go back to a place that used to give you so much difficulty. And then you just sort of... Just bring everyone down to Pound Town. You just go through and just wreck house everywhere. This lesser ripple of Taar's is really good. Because it does so much splash damage. Oh, actually, it's really good against low health enemies because it pretty much does enough damage to kill them outright. Rather than what it would be like if you went to try and use it against the Volks. Because it only does, what is it? Oops, put those on. It does 17 to 26, and a Volk had over 1,000 HP. So, it's really not going to be doing that much damage to a Volk. A Encase is better, but it takes so much mana that it's basically not even worth it. It does, and it only attacks one target, so it does 40, but it's 22 mana cost, and this is only 12 mana cost. So, considering how many people we have to kill all the time, it's better to just use area of effect spells. Plus, the most important thing for us is her raptor summon. So kill, well, there we go. That's how useful Taar can be, because she is. Here's me, when it comes to fighting. The scorpion. Okay, there's the Haku ceremonial blade, which we will grab. So we can now actually just finish that quest, which is pretty ridiculous how fast it was. It's just out that gate that we exited in, I think it was the last episode, before we just got annihilated by all of the enemies there. We may as well go to the Elven Shrine and do that quest as well, because that'll at least give us some monies with which we can hopefully equip our characters a little better. Let's just blow these up. Up, go. There's not really any point on taking the long way. We've been faffing around for so long that we may as well just take the teleporter back to town. Oh, man. I didn't realize how much time it actually took to get going in this game. I mean, when I'm commentating it all, it takes forever, but when I'm playing myself, it's quite easy. Wow, the Elven Shrine is so close to the actual town. That's interesting map design. I guess it would make sense that they'd put their town next to such a advanced civilization. It'd be good for trade. Wow, that's all very complicated when it doesn't need to be. Okay, so that'll do it for this episode. In the next one, we'll finish off Taar's quest and we'll go to the Elven Shrine and do the Elven Shrine's quest. So, thanks very much for watching and I'll see you all next time.